Let me get up here. So again, welcome everybody to this amazing day. It has been an absolutely amazing day. It really has. I've enjoyed it. I mean, the day's only just started and it's been absolutely fantastic. Now, for those that don't know me, I'm Emerson. I'm the best man. I've put a lot of effort into this speech, so I really hope you enjoy it. No pressure. I honestly didn't think this day would ever happen. Not because there's anything wrong with him, because there isn't. But like Vince said, he's just too laid back for his own good. I can only imagine that the lead up to this wedding, Charis was losing night's sleep, stressed. And I can guarantee Anthony didn't lose a minute's sleep at all. To be fair, this morning when I went round his house to fetch him, he was sat on the settee playing the PlayStation. That's literally how much he gives. Yeah. I was stressing, where's the suits? Where's the shoes? Have you got everything? He's like, yeah, let me just finish this game. I'm only probably going to get to be best man once because I've only got a couple of friends. One sat over there, the other one sat there. So I'm literally going to go all out. I've decided that if Charis falls out with me after this speech, yes, so be it. And I know she's stressing. Me and Anthony have known each other since school. We go way back. And in school, I'll always remember this one day where he was having this fight with this kid. Now, on paper, he should have won this fight. On paper, he should have won. there's only a couple of people in the room that even know this fight existed. Now, when you're at school and your friend's having a fight, you're not supposed to get involved. Win or lose, you're not supposed to get involved. But on this particular day, Auntie's getting his ass handed to him by this kid. He had a saviour. And that saviour was in the form of his sister. So Anthony's getting absolutely battered. Rachel comes busted in. She does. Absolutely slaps the shit out of this kid. Oh man. Like literally it was effortless. She battered him, this kid ran off, Ant's in the corner crying. Rachel went on to be cock of the school and Anthony never lived it down. Oh dear. For those, it was Simon Boff, by the way, you know it was. Okay, so I want to play a little game. I want you all to raise your hand if you've ever been on holiday abroad. Yeah, of course we are. These hands will start to drop the more I go into this. Put your hands up if you've been on holiday abroad with family. Yeah, of course. Put your hands up if you've been on holiday abroad with family and you've been on public transport. Train, coach, taxi. Yeah. Now put your hand up if you've been on holiday abroad with family and you've been on public transport and you fell asleep on the public transport and your family's got off and left you on the bus. So Anthony's on holiday. I think he's about 6 years old. He's on holiday abroad in Spain, I believe it was. You can put your hand down there, kid. He falls asleep on this bus. His family get off the bus. Where's Ant? The door's shut and the bus pulls off. Anthony, at 6 years old, is asleep on this bus and he doesn't wake up. I mean, no one else would wake up and think, shit, where am I? Oh, no, Ant. Ant gets woken up at the last stop by a Spanish driver going, patada, 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 patada. But there's things like this, the reason I just love him, because only things like this happen to him. And it makes him so unique, and it's why I love him. It's why I love him. Okay, so please put your hands up if you've been out with a friend on a school night. So you've been to the pub on a school night when you're supposed to not go. Yeah. Everyone. Put your hand up if you've been out on a school night and got really, really drunk when you're supposed to be at work the next day. Okay, I can get hands down. So put your hands up if you've been out with friends on a night out, on a school night, and you've got really drunk and you've decided it'd be a good idea instead of getting a taxi to walk home. So I'm pretty sure we've probably done that. Okay, so keep your hands up if you've been out on a school night with friends, got really drunk, decided to walk home, and on the way home, you've saw a nice field and decided to lie down and have a reminisce where you just talk about the past. Yeah, that's it. So me and Anthony thought it'd be a great idea on a school night to get really drunk and walk home, and we saw a field and thought, you know what, I can't be bothered to walk home, let's have a little lie down. Yeah, of course we both fell asleep. I woke up freezing cold about 3 o'clock in the morning, and I was literally this close to waking Anthony up, and I thought, hang on, shall I just leave him? So I left him. I was walking home creasing, because the part of the story I've left out is this field was opposite a primary school and it's a school night. Anthony rang me the next day. Can you all guess what time he rang me? It was about 8:30. He rang me going absolutely berserk. Why did you leave me? Why did you leave me? I was like, I tried to wake you up. No, I didn't. I left him. Anthony was woke up to the sound of a child going, Mommy, Mommy, who's that man? And the parent was going, get away from him, get away from him. He's the type of man that gives Moxley a bad name. Oh, man. Oh, I swear I tried to wake you up, Ant, I really did. Oh, dear. I've lost where I am now, I'm laughing so much. Okay, so put your hands up. Actually, no, I'm not. Forget put your hands up. I'm just going to tell this last story. I could go on and tell story after story after story, but I'm not going to do that because I'm conscious of time and how people want to enjoy the night. So I'm just going to tell you one more, and I'm just going to tell it. So Anthony came around my house, and we used to just sit up all night having sessions and just playing music and having a good time. And then at 1 o'clock in the morning, I'm like, Ant, I'm done. I'm going to bed. 1 o'clock in the morning, and Anthony's like, yeah, I'm going to go uptown on my own to meet Jams. I was like, Ant, it's 1 o'clock in the morning. You're not going to get in anywhere. He's like, no, I'm going. I was like, well, don't bother coming back to my house. To which he replied, no, man, just leave the door open. I didn't leave the door open. I then woke up about 3 o'clock to go to the toilet, and I had 17 missed calls off him. I was like, oh, shit. What's he done? I tried to ring him back. Of course, his phone's dead. He's not answering. So I go to the toilet. I'm having a wee, as you do. Yes, I need two hands. And I'm thinking, why have I got this horrible feeling that he's here? I've got this, he's here, I know he's here. So I go downstairs and check, and I can't find him. I check the front door, it's locked. I check the back door, it's locked. I'm like, I know he's here. So I get back in bed, and I check the cameras on my phone, and I notice that the foxes have been at the bin's knocked over. I'm like, well, I'm not going to leave that till tomorrow, because the foxes will just rip it out. So I go outside, I open the door, the ground is covered in snow, it's freezing cold. I walk over to the bin to clean the rubbish. I try and pick the bin up, and I can't. I open the lid of the bin. Who's in the bin?
I'm sleeping.
Anthony's fast asleep in my green bin, which stank, by the way. I was like, Ant, what are you doing? He's like, did I answer the phone? Honestly, you cannot make this shit up. It's only him that does this. But on a serious note, he is my best friend, and he's my best friend for a reason. Because a couple of years ago, which can be 8 years ago, I went through a really, really, really bad time. And he was there for me every single day. He would come around my house, he'd always bring beers, he'd always bring snacks. We'd sit up all hours, drinking and eating. I'd then go to work, he'd go to work, I'd come back, and then he'd always come back with more beers. I thought it was because he was a friend, but I think now it's because he had free lodging. He'd just sleep on the bed all the time. But no, seriously, I cannot wish for a better friend, because in times of need, you need good friends, and yeah, he was a very, very, very good friend. So, Charis, thank you for finally taking him off my hands. He's now yours to deal with. But on a serious note, you look stunning, and I genuinely believe you two are literally made for each other in every sense of the word. So can you all please raise your glasses and say cheers to the happy couple. I'm not done, by the way. I've saved the best for last. I need your help for the last part of my speech, if you don't mind. So during the rest of my speech, if I go like this, I want you all to say, premature. If I go like this, I want you all to shout, so good. So can we practice that, please?
So good.
I need louder. And if you hear me say Ant and Charis, I want you all to say tied the knot. So Ant and Charis. Ant and Charis. See, you let me down. You let me down. We'll try that again. Ant and Charis. We need to get this right, else I'm not doing it. So if I go like this, it's so good. Ant and Charis. I can't sing. I'm talking. It's the wrong one. It's the wrong one. Where it began, back in 2021, where their love began to grow. What?
Carry on. I need my words.
Can we, hang on, start again. Start again. I didn't go out, Start again.
I've got my words.
I'll try again. So. Where it began, back in 2021, this is where their love began to grow. Their first day was perfect. They talked all night.
Wait.
You have to wait. It's gone.
I need to do this properly. Began to grow. Ready?
Their first date was perfect. They sat talking all night. Venue.
One, two.
I'm not starting again. What was it that he saw in her? Cans. Charis's big cans. Reaching out, touching him, touching you. Sweet bride and groom, good times never felt so good.
Aunt
Charis. Like we always knew they would. In 2022, they bought their first house. This house needed some work, and they got to work straight away. Anthony did all of the electrics, and Charis painted every wall. But you'd all agree that it was Vince that did everything else. Hands. Vince's magical hands. Reaching out. Touching me, touching you. Sweet bride and groom. Good times never feel so good.
Stop it.
Aunt and Charis. Like we always knew they would. Can I ask that everyone gets on their feet for the last bit, please? And I want to hear you all singing along.
Stop it.
everyone together. Sweet bride and groom.
Sweet bride and groom.
Good times never felt so good. So good, so good, so good.
And Tom Curry's type and not like we always knew they would.
One more time.
Sweet bride and groom.
Bah, bah, bah. As loud as you can. Good times never felt so good.
So good, so good, so good. And Tom Curry's type and not like we always knew they would.
Please, big round of applause for the bride and groom.
Thank you.